Citadel base paints are designed to give a smooth, solid colour over an undercoat, and for that reason they will almost always be the first paints that you use on a miniature. Now I'm going to show you what these paints are like and how best to apply them. So as always, give the paint a good shake before you use it. And the colour I'm using here is Mephiston Red, which is going to form the main colour of this miniature, an Eldar Wraithguard. It's always a good idea to start with what the main colour is going to be. Now what you do is just get a dollop on your brush like this and put it on your palette. Now having it on the palette means you can control how much paint's on your brush, and also it means if it's a little bit thick you can water it down. Now to do this, just touch your brush to the surface of the water like that and just mix it in. You really don't need very much water. So it's just a case of applying it to the model like this. The brush I'm using is a base coat brush, and this is ideal for painting an area of colour like this. But if you're base coating something smaller, like say eyes or something like that, then just pick a smaller brush. But it's just an easy case of doing this. Now something to watch out for is making sure that you don't put too much paint on so that you don't start clogging up detail. If you can still see some of the undercoat through, however, like on here, then that's absolutely fine. Just let it dry and apply another coat later on. It's always, always best to apply multiple thin layers with base paint than it is one thick layer. Now, another great thing about these paints is not only will they cover undercoat, but also they'll cover other colours. So if you are a little bit messy at first and you happen to get some red on, say, his face here, which I'm later going to be painting white, it's not a problem because the base white paint will go over the top of that easily. Right, there we go. I finished applying all the base colours to him, but well, he's looking pretty cool already, isn't he? So the thing to remember about these paints is that they will almost always form the first colours that you apply to a model. When you apply them, I really recommend that you use a palette to help control how much paint you're using, and be very careful that you don't clog up the detail on the miniature. But now you've seen how easy they are to use, so go and check them out.